Hello guys and welcome back to a new video here at Architects3DP. If you remember, the last month we unboxed the xTool D1 Pro 20W laser engraver from xTool, which is a company specialized in laser engravers and cutters, as well as its accessories as you can see on their website. I did show you the three boxes, one of the laser we unboxed and the other two accessories that we are going to reveal in this video. Those accessories are the air assist set for the xTool D1 and the Rotary Attachment 2 Pro. So guys, today we are going to unbox and test those two accessories, and I guarantee you that they are going to completely blow your mind, both for the build quality as well as the results we get out of them. I'm gonna proceed with the unboxing, but before, I want to introduce you with our main channel sponsor that is no other than PCBWay. PCBWay is your website to not only get your PC prototypes the easy way, but also other services such as 3D printing or CNC machining. Today I have some good news in that area, since at PCBWay they have made an in-depth cooperation with FreeCAD, the open source parametric 3D modeler that I'm sure a lot of you use. Now, once you finish your design in FreeCAD, you can place an order on PCBWay with just one click. To use this service, you just have to go to Tools and Add-on Manager, choose PCBWay from the selection list and click Install. To find more information, please check out the link down in the description. Alright guys, so now yes, let's go for the unboxing. As you can see, we're going to start unboxing the Air Assist tool for the xTool D1. The first we can find when we open the box is some paperwork with instructions that I'm gonna leave here for now. Then we find a small cardboard box, and directly underneath we start finding more components such as this laser tip and this orange protector. Since this product is named as Air Assist 2 for the xTool D1 and we have the xTool D1 Pro 20W, I'm guessing we won't need these two accessories we found, since they came already included with our machine. Removing the piece of foam, we'll directly find the air compressor itself that comes with the power cord installed. Having a closer look, as you can see, the compressor looks very well built. It has a power switch that reminds me to the one on the lamp in my bedside table, but what is really cool are the flexible feet that will isolate any vibration produced in the compressor from the surface underneath. As I was saying, here we have the two accessories that I guess we'll not need for our machine, so I will continue by opening the small cardboard box that I have here. Inside we'll find the tube as well as some bolts, Allen keys and more accessories. With everything unboxed, guys, I'm going to proceed with the assembly of this really cool accessory to test how it actually works. So first we'll need this flexible tube and this attachment that will connect both parts together. To this end we'll insert one of the ends of the long tube, so the other one will be at the laser tip. Here we have the laser head with the connector we inserted before. Now the only thing we'll need to do is to insert it from the top like that, remove the cap and plug it in just like so. Once we have both ends finished, we'll just have to put everything together and start testing it. We'll go back to our xTool D1 Pro laser engraver and we'll insert the laser head in place, sliding it from the top. Once done, we'll set the focus and tighten the thumb screw on the left. Last step to put everything together is going to be to install the laser head connector we have removed before, and it will be ready to work. Okay guys, so to make the first test and check out how it works, I'm going to pick up an already ruined piece of wood and I'm gonna make the first test on it. So I have started the laser work on the air compressor, and I don't know if you can appreciate it on camera, but all the fumes are being blown away from the laser work area. What we can see is that it's working as intended, and we are ready to jump for a bigger test. When the laser works finishes, remember that you have to turn off the air pump, since there isn't any electronic connections whatsoever in between the laser machine and the compressor, and they work independently. But before going with the bigger test, what I'm going to do is to put every component we didn't use back in the box to store it properly and not lose any of the parts. Okay guys, so I'm gonna start our first project using the air pump, and it's going to be one of the example projects from xTool, the customizable foam holder. For what we'll need, one of the provided Basswood sheets and the project files that we'll directly download from the xTool Creative Space app. So the first step will be to align the wood properly with the help of the laser cross. As you can see, it is completely off center, so we'll rotate the wood, align it manually, and use the frame tool to check out if it's ready. Here we go. As you can see, now it's perfectly centered, so we'll send the laser work to our machine via Wi-Fi and we'll click Start. As you can see, it will start engraving our Architects3DP logo. And then it's going to start cutting. Here you have to notice that as the air pump is blowing air through the laser tip, the fumes are driven down, and all of them are escaping through the edges of the wood as you can see at the left, bottom and right. With that we get a very clean top surface, but not everything is good news, since we'll have a look at the bottom once the laser work finishes. As you can see, once finished, the laser did cut through perfectly. The parts can be removed very easily, but have a look at the bottom, guys. This second part as well looks perfect on the front, but having a look at the bottom side, the wood is very burnt. And I guess that's because of the fumes being blown through the bottom of the basswood. Apart from that, the project is a complete success as you can see. The score, engrave and cut works worked out fantastic. And here we have our phone holder, guys. I'm pretty sure this bottom issue has nothing to do with the laser or the air pump itself, but it is caused by the bottom support surface. We have been holding the basswood directly on top of the metal sheet, and I'm pretty sure that's why it got burned out at the bottom. Because, as I announced before, is that the blown air with the fumes has nowhere to go, and that's why it degrades the area near the laser cut. The solution for this issue can be addressed very easily using a honeycomb cutting bed. And for that, I'm going to borrow the honeycomb bed provided by xTool together with the new TS2 laser engraver that we recently reviewed in our channel, and you can check out clicking here. So once everything is ready, we'll do the framing of the work. And we can click start. In just 2 minutes, the work, as you can see, has finished, guys. It looks incredible, but the moment of truth has come. In our first try, the front face was looking just perfect, and was at the back where we found all the issues. With this laser work, the top surface looks fantastic, and at the bottom face, as we can see here, it is looking as good as at the top face, which is a great success. Don't mind this bump right here, since it is from a previous test I made with the machine. As you can see, the laser work has been marked into the honeycomb, but what matters to us is that it's looking just perfect on both sides. If we compare the negatives of the cutting boards, again on the front both look fantastic, but at the back, just the difference by yourself. So here we have our new cutting project complete, guys. Engraving wise, as you can see in this laser job, the machine works as good or even better than cutting. But that's not everything for this video, guys, since we have more, and that's gonna be the Rotary Attachment 2 Pro. Back to the laser box sent by xTool, we'll find the last accessory that we're going to review inside. We can find, as always, some paperwork with instructions, a piece of protective foam, a cardboard box, and the real deal here at the bottom. Having a closer look, we'll find some cables and tools, some accessories, all of them built in solid aluminium, the base of the Rotary Attachment, some bolts, some more accessories, and a bubble level. Finally, in the cardboard box, we'll find some more parts. Here we have a measuring tape, more accessories, tools, and so on. Here we have another attachment for the unit, and a really cool device right here. My plan here is going to be to engrave my glass water bottle with a cool design. And for that, I'm going to dig into the instructions to check out how to proceed. According to the instructions, it seems that the current position of the rollers, that is, AC, is meant for bigger diameter objects, so we'll need to close that gap and go to the position AB. For that, we'll need to remove this bolt right here at the bottom holding the roller in place, which will allow us to directly remove it and insert it in the B position just like that. Once done, we'll set the holder back in place with the bolt we removed. Now, as you can see, the bottle sits on top of the roller, and it's not touching at the bottom as before. Back to the laser, now we'll need to unplug this connector right here that powers the y-axis of the machine, since we'll use this same port to connect the rotary attachment, being the rolling axis, the y-axis of the machine now. Once done, we'll just need to put it in place just like that, plug in the motor and insert the leg extensions to raise the whole machine. For that, we'll remove the rubber cap and screw in the new leg. We're actually going to install 2 extensions per leg, so here's the second one. To make it a bit faster, we can connect the double extensions first, and then insert them in every corner just like so. Here's the last one, and now we are ready to go. We'll now focus the laser as we always do, and I'm going to paint the glass bottle black with a very cheap spray paint that I bought from the dollar store. the paint has to be easy to remove later on. So here we have our blacked out bottle that we're going to set in place. We'll center the laser with the help of the cross laser and measure the perimeter and length to configure the software. Now we'll frame the work to see if everything is in its position, and once done, we'll just hit the start button and wait till the work is done. The laser job, as you can see, took a while, but it's finally done, and it's looking insane, guys. If you use a metallic can and make this kind of job, it will look just like this amazing bottle we just tuned, guys. However, this is a glass bottle, and now we have to remove the paint. So after removing all the paint and filling it with water, this is the final result. As you can see, it looks just great. Having a closer look with this angle, as you can see, the engraving work is insane. And I think I'm going to engrave all my bottles now. Alright guys, so I hope you loved this Rotary Attachment 2 Pro. As you can see in their website, it is the world's first 4-in-1 rotary attachment for laser engraver. Since a part of the roller rotary we just used to engrave a bottle, you can use it to engrave even a glass of wine. With the chuck rotary, you can engrave different objects such as mugs. With the sphere rotary, you can make, for example, your own Christmas balls. And with the ring rotary, you can engrave different objects such as rings, holding them from the interior. We have no more time to make more tests with the rotary attachment, guys. But if you want us to make a new video with this tool, please leave a lot of comments down below. Finally, please make sure you are subscribed to the channel, consider supporting our work on Patreon as all these amazing people does, and as always, see you in the next video.